I'd catch up tonight. I know I probably should be going to bed, but we're getting ready to come up on a holiday weekend, so I do get one day off this week, but I probably won't vlog. I may vlog the day. I don't know. It depends. I'm waiting for a hair delivery from Platinum Wigs, and I want to, with the special that's going on right now, so I'm going to want to review that ASAP so that you guys can get there and order and use your VIP code of 136 and get the new styles. They have two human hair. One you have to get in the burgundy color, 99J, and the other one you can get in any color you want. It's the loose bang that you cut yourself, which I don't know how that's going to work, but I wanted it. It's human hair. And then you can get a Remy for free. So I ordered another body wave in the color, the darker color, because the one I got last time was a 4 and it was kind of light. What I have on tonight is the Malva. It's a wig, not a lace front. It's a human hair wig. I don't know what's been going on. I think, for some reason my skin's been really sensitive, and gluing down the hair pieces, I've caused some burning along my scalp. I may show you guys, on another video. It's real dark right there. It's kind of gnarly looking, but, I don't know if it's because the glue is older and it just got weird, or my skin's gotten really sensitive. Sometimes your skin changes as, you know, you get older, whatever, or what. But it's really been causing some irritation. So I've been trying to wear more wigs, or using the little wigget gripper stuff just to hold my hair in place. So right now I haven't been playing in my hair a lot. But this is the Malva, M-A-L-V-A. It's a human hair wig, and I'm going to curl it tonight before I go to bed so I can wear it to work tomorrow. Work's winding down. We've got probably another 10 days of this assignment. I've just been so excited to have it. I mean, I hadn't worked in so long, and I know it didn't pay very much, but to have this work for the last couple of months has really, 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 really come in handy and made ends meet. Sometimes you have to make success where it just doesn't appear that there is one. You have to not be pretentious and be proud and be able to accept whatever happens, because the doors that open sometimes are opening the way they're opening for a reason. And even though I'm not using my degree or using my qualifications right now, being able to get back to work and make my ends meet have kept a really bad domino from happening. I mean, despite how qualified you are, if you don't have any money coming in, you don't have any money coming in. So my book just released, and there's always kind of a gap between a novel releasing and the publisher paying. So that's when usually I try to work a temp job. And with the economy, nothing had come through. So, frankly, I was thankful that this came through. And as always, I learned something new on this job. I learned the banking business. Interesting stuff, I may tell you. Very interesting stuff. So, it looks like we probably have another 10 days on this assignment. They haven't talked any extensions, but I'm doing pretty good. So, who knows? I may get in on the extensions. Right now, we're considering a move back to California. I'm all for that. I'm ready. I've given Portland, Oregon about 10 years, and it's really afforded me to complete my education and really just enjoy the cool weather, the rain, snow, and a really beautiful place to live. So I have no regrets living here for the last 10 years. Culture is a little different, and it's been a little hard to fully enmesh myself in the culture. And despite being here 10 years, I'm not an Oregonian. I mean, it's just not, it's not who I am. And I think I've done okay here, but my heart, I've left my heart in San Francisco, and I'm ready to go back and get it. Now, I say that, and, you know, I planned it in 2008. I actually went. In 6 months, I had to come back. You know, the economy bottomed out, and I couldn't find work. So I'm going to try it again. I'm gung-ho, and I'm going to go. Gonna try to bust back in there again, and all I can hope is that I get work and I'm able to go back home. There's reasons. I mean, my mom's getting older, and I want to be, call me at 8, I'm there at noon. I want to be a couple hours from her, not a day, not a day trip. I want to be a couple hours from my mom, and I just kind of miss my family, and I do kind of miss I miss my life. Oregon's kind of one of those BYOL places, bring your own life kind of places. And I'm ready to go back to where my life is just kind of there. I've got some exciting business things coming up, and I'm going to be sharing them with you guys as they come along. You guys know I started selling Mary Kay. I've always sold the artist garments, those shape-fitting garments, I'm looking into starting to sell this new product, this jewelry product called Paparazzi, and I have started sewing again, and so I'm going to be sewing wardrobers that are going to be part of a fashion line that I'm going to start selling. I have applied to school. Yes, I'm going after a second PhD. This one actually is going to be a psych degree. So it's a PsyD. It's a psych doctorate. And with that, I'm going to be doing not necessarily clinical psychology, because I don't have a master's in psychology. So I can't do clinical, but I can do industrial organizational psychology. So basically, if I'm hired by a company to consult and train, I'll be able to do the assessment to that training and be able to give the corporation my recommendations on that. I could be an efficacy specialist, which is what I kind of like doing. I can work in gender diversity issues and things like that in the workplace and conflict resolution. Additionally, I'll be able to diagnose things, not treat it. Like, for instance, if I diagnose alcoholism, I can give that result, and then that person can be recommended off to something else. I can diagnose depression, but I can't treat it. So that's going to be kind of interesting, too, being able to take assessments and offer diagnoses for different things. It's just going to be a fascinating program. It's about 3 years long, but that's okay. I'm learning every day. Why not continue to learn in a formal setting? I don't have a problem with that. The expense isn't that bad either. If somebody wants to know about the cost of going to Capella University, just ask me down in the box down there, and I'll give you the information and recommend Capella. I recommend Capella to anybody. I think it's probably a little higher on the private end, a higher end for private schools, but overall, I think it's competitive to all the rest that are out there, and I really have enjoyed my education. As you see, I'm going back, giving them some more of my time. As far as the teaching certificate for the online certification program for online instruction, I'm really hoping to use that. And frankly, it's just been pretty hard trying to use stuff here. I don't mean to sound like I'm whining or anything, but I would like to go to California to be able to take the CBES and start subbing in some of the schools that are really willing to hire. I mean, everybody says they need a teacher, but then you're not able to make the right connections to get in. And I've already made some connections in California, and I've already spoken to some of the people I need to speak to. I know networking's really big here, and that's fine. But I do have some inroads. You know, I kind of have that kind of going on in my life. I guess I'm feeling kind of awkward because, you know, I get kind of beat up every day about, oh, Michelle, it's on you. You're the reason you don't know anybody. You're the reason you don't get out. And so I'm trying to defend myself in that I have a life. I do have a life. And for 10 years, I've kind of stepped out of it to accomplish some things. And so I'm kind of ready to kind of step back into it and get pretty active in the things that I really do enjoy doing. That's kind of the size of that. Other than that, let's see. Oh, my shoulder's been really hurting, you guys. It's not getting any better, and it's been really sore, and I can't put it over my head, and I don't know what that's all about. And the gallstones haven't gone away, and they've been hurting, and I want to have surgery, and they won't do it. And I've been eating a lot of soup, and I've been losing a lot of weight, which is wonderful. Oh, I'm supposed to be sad about that. Anyway, I've been glad about that. I have lost some more weight. I'm actually getting back to where I was at the beginning of the year when I got sick. I'm kind of going back to zero. So, but I'm glad because I was really worried. I packed on about 15 pounds with the gallstones. And so that's off, just about off. I got about two, three more pounds to get back where I was in February. Then I can get back on track for losing more weight. I think my body has accepted that it's not going to get food. And so, therefore, the gallstones have acted accordingly. Because that's the reason the gallstones kick in. You lose weight quickly and your body gets confused on how much bile to produce. and the stones create, and I don't understand why, but they do that. So now I think that because it's still not realizing I don't need that much because I'm not going to eat that much food, I think it's kind of coming around. I won't say, I mean, last time I was so gung-ho, I hadn't taken any pain pills, but I have to confess, I had a half of a Norco about 2 weeks ago. I thought I was going to make a trip to ER, and I really didn't want to because I'm on this temp assignment, and I really needed to make some dough. I didn't want to take the days off from working. And then everything kind of got right, and then the other day, I took an ibuprofen, one. But since I haven't taken it in so long and I haven't been eating, it kind of worked like alcohol on an empty stomach. I took the one ibuprofen and pain was gone. So that's pretty good. I don't mind just taking the one ibuprofen. I mean, I was up to some big doses of ibuprofen and that was just really bad. We were supposed to get snow the past weekend. We did it. We got a really heavy frost, which was nice too, but kind of wanted to see some snow. This could be my last winter. I'd like to see some snow. That's okay. You can find snow in California if you look really, 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 really hard. So anyway, didn't have a lot to say. I just kind of wanted to check in. Feeling really good, really positive. Stuff's happening. Stuff's changing. Decided on the name of my business. It's going to be Head, Shoulders, Knees, and Toes. Stay tuned. And I'd like to be able to offer everybody my services. I think it's going to be a great opportunity for anybody, but especially women, to come in and reinvent. It's going to be a makeover business, basically. It's for you to come in, make over, and leave feeling better about yourself, inside and out. I'm going to incorporate my Shackley business, my artists, everything that I'm into these days. So that's what I'm doing there. Still trying to take care of myself, trying to take care of my family, trying to take care of my kids. Mister's doing okay. Everybody's doing okay. Everybody's doing okay. And just got to keep hanging in. You got to stay positive. I was on the radio tonight at artistfirst.com with Dr. Maxine Thompson. And we talked about that, yeah, you got to cry. Sometimes you got to cry, you got to whine, you got to drink, you got to complain. And you need to do that with people you trust who aren't going to throw it in your face later. So, yeah, it's okay. But then you got to eventually pull yourself back up and look for the next thing to do and find the next door that's open. Doors aren't going to just blam, open up and hit you all in the face. You have to push against the doors to find the one that's going to open for you. And you can't be afraid to do that. You just won't keep living. You won't make it to the age I am, and you won't make it any further if you're too afraid to live. And I don't mean bungee jumping. I'm talking practical. I'm talking finding out what's in your head, that realizing what you're thinking, formulate your thoughts into actions, and then act on them to make your life go in the direction it needs to go. If you need to lose weight, don't just say it. Do what you need to do to do it. If you need to get out of a bad relationship, don't just say it. Get the resources that you need to do it. If you want to get educated, investigate it. Do what you need to do to get it done. If you need to get healthy, investigate it. I mean, with the internet, there's nothing that you can't find out these days. And vice versa, people can find out stuff about you because it's out there. It's out there. And investigate what's positive. Investigate what's going to work for you. Investigate what's good, what's healthy. Investigate what's going to progress you forward and not hold you back and keep you down and depressed. So that's my gung-ho speech for tonight. That's my vlog for tonight. Kind of tired. I really didn't have much to say. Kind of rambled. But I hope I've been just kind of filled you guys in and had some positive things to say to people that are listening, to my fans and my fans and subscribers, and those that just want to be my friends and my family. Good night. Talk with y'all later. But next time I'm on here, I'll probably be doing a review. You know how much I love doing those. Probably going to put on my Mary Kay face and show you guys how that looks. I bought a new sweater. I'll have that on too, so you guys can see how that looks too. Hey. And I'll talk with you later. Bye.